borderline. But we pass crisscross.
Welcome. A very nice and warm welcome to this first episode of the Freeway Lectures. The Apartheid Studies Freeway Lectures. That's what we are going to be calling them. The Freeway Lectures, because I deliver these lectures as I drive on the freeway. So as long as I'm driving on the freeway, these lectures will keep coming. I am your host, Nyasha Mboti, and I'm the founder and pioneer of a new field of studies. Known as apartheid studies. My book on the subject, in fact, 4 volumes on the subject, will be hitting the shelves in 2021, where I've developed a framework of what I call apartheid studies. And so it is a really warm welcome. I don't know if it's a really warm welcome because it's a little bit chilly here, driving out of Johannesburg. It's cloudy. It's been raining the whole of this week. And it looks like it's gonna rain again anytime soon. So the purpose of these freeway lectures is to address some of the key topics in the new field of apartheid studies, to unveil the framework of apartheid studies, expand and amplify this new space, initiate debate and dialogue, and to draw on insights from a variety of sources and multiple places, sites and locations. And ultimately achieve some of the key objectives of apartheid studies. The key objective being, of course, that apartheid studies is a theory of liberation. And so ultimately, the goal of apartheid studies is to put apartheid on trial, because up to this point it has managed to escape accounting for its crime scenes. And so the forensic method of apartheid studies is fashioned precisely to close those loopholes that allow apartheid studies to persist when officially it is supposed to have died, officially it is supposed to have ended. So this introductory lecture is just an introduction to the whole concept of freeway lectures. An introduction to the concept of apartheid studies. So today I'm going to be taking you on a journey. Into how apartheid studies began and some of the key foundational issues that are behind the whole formulation of apartheid studies as a new field of studies that seeks to bring apartheid to trial. We are going to be having these lectures in a weekly and fortnightly format, in weekly and fortnightly intervals. All the lectures will be happening right here in this beast, this Haval H6. Absolutely love this car. It drives beautifully. We'll be driving at about 100 kilometers an hour. So it's lectures at the speed of 100 kilometers an hour. I could do more than that, but I don't like speeding. It's not good. It's not good for your health. It's not good for your life. When I was a little bit younger, when I had my first car, I did try to push that speed limit, and let me just say, I was taught a lesson. In terms of how not to drive and how to drive. So I don't want to go back there. So it is actually quite a nice space to be in as I'm driving for the next 400 kilometers to just discourse with you and dialogue with you. I'll just put the car on cruise control, 100 k's an hour as I said, and then we just hit the road and we discuss. In this initial lecture, it's not live, but I hope that in future installments it will actually be possible for me to be doing these freeway lectures live. It is still a beautiful day today, despite the threats of rain, constant threat of rain. Dark clouds up ahead. Looks good as we are driving out of Johannesburg. So now I'm getting onto the freeway. Can you hear that? Can you hear the beast go far, far, far? Oh man, I love this car. So that was just gear number 5. And I think I should push it into gear number 6 in a moment. Alright, let's get into gear number 6. And let's get to 100. Cruise control. Let's go. All right. Let's perhaps start this lecture on a musical tip. just to let you sample some of the music that I have on my playlist. It's mostly reggae music because that is my favorite. I have some blues and some Mbira music. It's really an eclectic collection of music that I have. So it has actually started to rain. I didn't expect the rain so early, so I might have to put on my wipers imminently. It's not raining heavily, it's just a drizzle, but enough for me to put on the wipers. So in terms of my musical interests, I think let us just start on a Chimurenga tip. I think this one is a track by one of the legendary musicians from Zimbabwe, Thomas Mafumo, who literally invented his own genre of music, which fuses traditional Mbira music, drums, osho, with what you'd call modern instruments such as the guitar. So let's hear a little bit from Thomas. Song by Thomas Mafumo, like I said, and the title is Hondo, and basically he's saying we don't want war, and he's saying, have you noticed that when there is war, it is the poor who are sacrificed. It is the poor who die, and affluent, the wealthy, the rich, they always find a way to exempt themselves. The In our lectures, we are going to get to a discussion of these peculiar forms of exemption, but that's only in future installments. Today, I would like to just talk in a very introductory way so as to ease us gently into this quite needful discourse of apartheid studies. So, you might ask, you might be asking, you might want to know, what is apartheid studies? I'm not going to be giving a standard definition of apartheid studies just yet. That is the job of several iterations of these freeway lectures. But I'd like to start you off with the understanding that the purpose, the objective of apartheid studies is to enact a specific practice that I call loophole closing. The purpose and objective apartheid studies, at least as I'm going to frame it in this introductory lecture, is that apartheid studies is a practice, or the practice, of loophole closing. What do I mean by loophole closing? Several things, but I'm going to start off on a note that many of you who watching and listening might easily identify with. So I'll start with a date. I'll start with the historical date. May 1994. That is the date we are going to begin with. That is going to be our opening point in our attempt to frame and define the notion of a loophole. Because I did mention that apartheid studies enacts the specific practice of loophole closing. So what then is a loophole? And so, in trying to frame this question and this definition, we will start on that specific date. 10 May 1994. So what happened on this day? What happened on this date? There was an eclipse on the 10th of May, 1994. And this cosmic event is going to return again and again in our discussion. Some of the important figurative symbolism of apartheid. But there was an eclipse on 10 May 1994. An eclipse that in Chinese mythology, an eclipse is framed as an event when the dragon eats the sun. Eclipse mythologically is understood as an event when the great big dragon swallows the sun. This happened on 10 May 1994. An eclipse is an important starting point because it is a cosmic and lunar and solar event that marks a moment of transformation. Many elite ancient priest classes used eclipses as moments of change. Of course, they could predict when the eclipse was going to happen. And they knew or assumed that ordinary people, the common people, didn't know. And so they attached great symbolism to this prediction of this almost apocalyptic event that is going to happen, or that was going to happen, when for a moment the sky was darkened. In my culture, the Shona word, so-called Shona, of course, because there's no such language as Shona. It's a colonial construct. But the Shona word for an eclipse, for the phenomenon of an eclipse,